really quickly, I'm going to run through my UFC 138 picks. First, to say that this card is taking place in Birmingham in England. I am not going. Firstly, I didn't find the card interesting enough, and I don't have enough money to do it this year. Secondly, I did go to Birmingham to the National Indoor Arena once. How was that? To see Cage Rage, and that is in fact relevant for this because one of the people I saw on that card was Shane Mills, and he is making his debut in this event. So there we are. Anyway, I didn't like Birmingham. So, you know, I wouldn't go back there, would I? Right, let's carry on. Going to do my usual, I'm going to make my prediction on my main event first, and then start at the bottom and work up. So, Chris Leben and Mark Munnoz. You know, I think this is going to be quite a hard one to call, because Mark Munnoz is actually very good indeed. I do, however, err towards Chris Leben. He's got the longer record, and he's a little bit more feisty, I think, on the feet. It's going to definitely be a striking match. I'm going to go for Chris Leben. I shall go for TKO in the third there. Chris Carriasso is fighting Vaughn Lee. Chris has a record of 11-3. Often ends up winning by decision, and his record is loss, win, loss. Vaughn Lee is somebody who did partake in Cage Gladiators, and I sort of remember him. He was fighting Ashley Grimshaw, which I was more taken with at the time, so I don't remember him as well as I could have done. He's got a record of 11-6, both wins and loses by submission. I think he might take this one. I'm going to go for him, but I'll go for decision on that. Chris Cope is fighting Shay Mills. Chris Cope has a record of 5-1. He's fought very little in the way of calibers. Shay Mills, you know, he's got records 13-4. He, like I said before, Cage Rage. He's fought many calibers. He's also on a 4-fight win streak. I think he's going to get a TKO victory. I go for TKO in the second there. Rob Broughton is fighting Phil DeFries. Phil has a perfect record of 7, all of which are by submission. Rob Broughton, you know, he's a bit more well-rounded, 15-6. He is coming off a loss, but I think he will win this one. I might go for him winning by choke, RNC, in the first. That would be ironic, considering that's what Phil DeFries always wins by. If you don't count his no contest. Or was it a draw? I can't remember which one. No, I think it was a no contest. Anyway, moving on. Mishihiro Omigawa is fighting Jason Young. Now, Mishihiro has a record which is nearly equal. It's only 12-10. He is, in fact, coming off 2 losses. Jason Young, 8-4. I think he will win. I shall go for decision. John Maguire is fighting Justin Edwards. Justin Edwards, 7-1. He's never been finished. He is a George Gergel apprentice, so to speak. John Maguire is somebody who, apparently, according to his record, was quite well present in Cage Gladiators. I don't remember him at all. So there we are. Record 16-3, and he is on a 5-fight win streak, but this is his debut. I fancy his chances on this one, you know. Both of them like submissions. It's going to be a ground match. I shall go for John Maguire winning by bar submission in the third. Cyril Diabate and Anthony Parosh. Anthony Parosh, record of 11-6, and his record loss, win, loss, win. He is a likes to win by submission, so he's a groundsman, whereas Cyril is a stand-up fighter with a record of 17-7. I think I'm going to go for him. I shall go for TKO in the second there. Paul Taylor is the sort of one who wins some and loses some, but somehow always seems to be a perennial flower in the UFC, and sometimes they put him up against people that he can easily beat, and sometimes they use him in squash matches like this one. He's got a record of 11-6. He is his record is loss, win, loss, loss, win, as I just explained. He is fighting Anthony Nojokwani, the big guy from WEC, one of the big guys from WEC, you know, along with Takai Mizugaki and Jeff Curran and that lot. His record, 14-5, loss, loss, win, loss, win. He should have no problem with this if he's on top form. I'm going to go for him by bar submission in the first there. Especially as Paul Taylor doesn't do well with calibers at all. Edward Falalalalalalaloto is fighting Terry Eaton. Terry Eaton has a record of 14-3, and Edward has won as much as he's lost, and that's not saying much considering he's only had four fights. This is Terry Eaton's first fight of this year, which is interesting because they're not using some of the British fighters as often as I feel they should, but there we are. I still think he'll win. I'll go for a choke submission in the first there. Thiago Alves, now where has he been? It's quite funny because I feel like he hasn't fought in ages. He has not had such a good time since he didn't manage to beat Georges St Pierre, and he burst into tears about it on the way back to his locker room, actually. I don't know why I'm laughing at that. It's late at night, I'm feeling a bit... Anyway, he's from American Top Team, and his past record at the moment, loss, loss, win, loss, they are putting him up against somebody who he should have no problem with. They obviously want him still in the UFC, because he's fighting Papi Abedi. Papi Abedi looks a little bit like a bodybuilder, and he has got a perfect record of 8, but he has fought absolutely no calibers at all, and this is his first fight this year, and despite his area of strength being TKO, I don't think he's going to be much of a match for Thiago Alves' boxing skills. So I'm going to go for TKO in the first by Thiago Alves there. And finally, Brad Pickett versus Renan Barreiro. Barreiro is his nickname because his real name is three dozen sentences. Renan blah 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 Pagoda, I believe, or something like that. Anyway, never mind about that. Brad Pickett, veteran on the English scene, should be able to win this one. I'm going to go for submission. I'll go for a bar submission in the third. And those are my predictions for UFC 138.